Repeat. The automatic defense system is active.
Hello everyone, Shadefire here, and welcome back to Let's Play Cold Fear. This is episode 8, and this might actually be the final episode. Last time, we finally found Kamsky's notes, but we decided to only send the antidote to our CIA contact, who was not happy about that, but we gave him the finger. And then we got back in touch with Anna, who wants to blow up the whole platform, so we went and got some C4 from down here.
I've got the C4.
I've marked the places for you to set the charges. Start with the underwater elevator, then take care of the bridge control room, which is next to the scientific module, and finish with the room before the heliport gate.
I'll meet you there when I'm done.
Alright, so we know where all of those is, and our objective did say we have to place them in the right order, so we can't just go to any of those. So first we have to go to the underwater tunnel elevator, which I kind of remember where that is. Also, wasn't there a lot more enemies in here when we ended the last episode? Yeah, so we just have to get this C4 planted before the exocell inside of Tom reaches his brain. Alright, so we gotta get out of this area. There's a lot of traps in here, but are there gonna be any enemies? I say right as we get a cutscene. That didn't work. I didn't think the spear would actually set off the explosive. Honestly, don't even feel like we need the explosives for these guys. Yeah, that was a lot less enemies than I was expecting based on the amount of shit around this room. Out of spears. Pretty full up on everything else. I feel like this is one of the first games where the grenade launcher is kind of shit, in addition to the flamethrower. Because, like, I've yet to see a practical application for it. Alright, so let's see. Underwater tunnel elevator. I think that's just on the other side of this, but it might not be accessible from here. I think we might have to go back up and then come down. Nope. I mean, considering how many of these things are in here, you would think this is the right way. Is actually the right way. Because didn't it say last time we came down here that the elevator must be somewhere else? Alright, thankfully she went around and actually put a big X where we need to put the C4. Okay, did not think that we were going to set it for 5 seconds. By the way, Tom, after you place it, you better fucking run! Alright. So we put the microwave on here. Great! He's locked! Oh, God. Okay. So, yeah, we can't go out that door because the elevator's on the wrong floor, so we need to go back out through the tunnel. Alright, good to know. I'm glad they put a save point right before this so you could learn these things, but there is a diary page here, so we'll grab that first. October 16th, we have obtained excellent results with the latest strain of Victor's serums. However, while they are preventing the exocells from killing their hosts, the poor souls continue to undergo hideous and painful mutations. The serum also seems to speed up certain phases of the process. What we are creating here can only be called monsters. October 19th, one of the experimental subjects is driving me mad. I don't understand why Victor insists on keeping his failures. This thing is constantly bellowing and climbing the walls and ceiling of its cell. It is a good thing that it hates the light. otherwise it would be virtually uncontrollable. But the shouting, it goes on all night. The sound of it chills my blood. October 20th. It stared at me all day in the lab. I could feel its eyes on me everywhere I went. A. Karev and L. Bartolovich had noticed my fear of it. Why won't Victor destroy it? October 21st. Today I caught that damnable creature trying to take apart its cell. I swear it started smiling at me when I saw it. I forced it back into a corner with a strong light before fetching a technician. M. Purev to repair the damage. It howled the entire time, as if to let me know that someday it will come for me. October 22nd. It has apparently acquired new powers. I spent all day watching it, and to my horror I discovered that its howling made all the lights in the entire scientific module go out. Okay, so that is the crawling monster that we fought a couple times. Fortunately, the power was quickly re-established, but it gave that hideous scream and the lights died again. I tried talking to Victor about it, but he would have none of it. October 23rd. Today we infected the last of the prisoners Yusupov had brought in for use as test subjects. Kamsky used an additional 20 centiliters of serum A412, but the results looked the same, uncontrolled asymmetrical mutation. I think these test subjects will be put down. A. Briklov and B. Dubowski will do the necessary as usual. Victor is furious. Like me, he feels that we are on the verge of a breakthrough, and that only a few more subjects are needed. Whilst I do not feel remorse, my sleep is haunted by terrible nightmares. Even if the test subjects are dangerous criminals, they deserve better than this. I will be glad to go back to working on apes and other lesser creatures. October 29th. One of Anishenko's men went missing today. November 1st. An experimental specimen vanished this morning. I do not mean that it escaped. It vanished. All that could be seen was a slight disturbance in the air like some sort of heat mist. It is terrifying to think of the powers that we may be unleashing here. We have established beyond all doubt that the missing specimen is still in its containment cell. Its aggression and insanity must have reached a threshold after which it started bashing itself against the walls of its confinement in an attempt to escape. When it struck hard enough to injure itself, it faded into view for a moment and tried to escape. Clearly, injury renders it visible. Is this its last trace of humanity? So is this just going to go over every enemy we've already seen? Because I feel like this note wasn't here before. November 3rd, we have taken to filling this specimen's chamber with a fine mist, which enables us to better observe it. Its appearance is most strange. Death no longer seems to be at work. November 4th, two more guards, A. Barov at B. Martinev, have disappeared. Anishenko is accusing anyone and everyone. Victor is strangely calm, arguing that they probably got drunk and fell overboard. This is plausible, these mercenaries crave only their weapons, alcohol, and sex, and yet, Victor's lack of concern is disquieting. I wish I could believe him. This is also like the longest note we've ever seen. November 10th. When I came into the lab this morning, it was clear that someone had been working there all night. I immediately suspected C. Kambiev at D. Fernandenko, two assistants I don't trust. I asked Victor about it, and he said I was imagining things, that I had been working too hard. He was the last person here in whom I kept a little trust. I often think of my university friend D. Florianov. I should have taken his advice, but it's too late now. Also, who lists, like, other people at their work by first letter and last name? November 16th, Yusupov left today aboard the whaling ship. He claimed he was going with Lubensky to make sure they get some good specimens for the lab. I think he just wants to get away from Victor. At first, Yusupov had to use Anna as a hostage to get Victor to work for him, but now Kamsky is more enthusiastic about it than Yusupov. It is a strange reversal of roles. Anna also went along, of course. I find myself fearing for her safety. But perhaps she is safer with Colonel Dmitry Yusupov than she is here. November 20th, another mercenary, F. Pirov, has vanished. Anishenko is beside himself with anger. He blames American spies, an old habit. November 24th, one of the Exocell containment chambers is empty. We are now all in terrible danger. Victor seems unconcerned, claiming that the creatures died so he threw it overboard. I was furious. I told Victor that if one of the creatures dies, we have a scientific duty to study it to find out why. Two other researchers, O. Floretsky and J. Loranev, agreed with me, but Victor replied by saying he had learned all he wanted from that specimen. He also said that he had come up with a solution to the problem of not having what he called appropriate subjects. He would say no more on the subject, however, telling me that I should not worry myself with such details, especially when the work on the antidote was going so well. December 1st, two more mercenaries, A. Delbev and T. Desayev, are missing. Anishenko is preparing for an assault. He reckons there must be a breach in the magnetic jamming. I think he's barking up the wrong tree. December 3rd, we established radio contact with the whaler today. A storm is moving in, making communication very difficult. However, I'm sure you heard them say that they thought there were exocells on board. I felt my blood go cold. Anishenko gave them orders to turn back, but there was no reply. They have not responded to any of our calls since. I surprised myself praying for the souls of those on board, especially for Anna, whose only misdeed is being the daughter of her father. December 4th. Today is a day of calamity. Victor has vanished, his notebooks are missing, as is his laptop. The samples of serum and antidote we were working on, gone too. Perhaps he has gone mad and thrown himself into the sea, unable to bear the things he has done. Personally, I don't think so. I am convinced he has decided to experiment upon himself, and that he is hiding somewhere, awaiting metamorphosis. He often said that his ultimate objective was to arrest the exocell process. He said it would be a tremendous feat to harness the creature's power, mutations, and subsequent changes of personality. If I ever set eyes on him again, I do not think I will recognize him. Hopefully all this is a bad dream. God help us if he has succeeded. December 5th. Still no word from the whaler, still no sign of Victor. And today, someone released the last remaining specimens from the laboratory. They are now roaming all over the platform, and the exocells are breeding like wildfire. Anishenko has barricaded himself in with his men, but it is useless. I await certain death. Victor, what have you done? This time, I was very nearly done for. I'm going to take refuge in the sick bay. As far as I'm aware, there have been no attacks there. I'm taking the last prototype and a dose of the antidote. I know there are others in Kamsky's lab, but I can't bring myself to go there. Anna will come looking for me. Please hurry, Anna. I'm afraid there may not be much left of me by the time you get here. Two helicopter pilots, C. Lekachev and J.B. Beletsky, have been killed. Anna is now the only one who can save me. Alright, so that kind of chronicled the fall of the rig. So, we plant this here, we run through the door, and then the tunnel's probably going to collapse behind us. So we keep running. Oh man, it's one of those awful reverse perspective chase sections. Ah! Oh, come on. I was mashing E, but when the camera changed, he started walking to the side. That note again. But yeah, this is really shitty because they haven't had one of these in the entire game, and now they're like, yep, here's the chase cam. Alright, we gotta be almost there. The problem is when the camera changes, I'm letting go of space, thinking it's going to mess me up. But no, we just have to keep holding it and keep going the same direction. Yeah, very good thing there's a save point here. See, like, because I'm still holding W right now as I'm running, but if I let go of that, he'll switch directions. There we go, we made it. And I guess the door, you know, it's a bulkhead, so it's sealed against that. Alright, are these guys finally going to break out? Because, I mean, they have to, right? Okay, where's our next one? Second charge on the marker in the scientific module bridge control room. Well, that one we know where it is. Pretty sure it's right at the top of the shaft. Out here. Scientific module, yep. Alright, now, do you think I'm gonna have to run across the bridge after we blow it up? Because that seems like bad planning on Tom's part. So there's the X. Yeah, I guess we'll just bolt across the bridge before it collapses. Thankfully, that one was a lot easier to manage. Okay, and then the final one is upper corridor leading to the heliport. I don't really remember exactly where the heliport is, but it's like up in that area above where we fought the first one of the runny guys, so gotta get back there first. Which means we need to go, yeah, past the med bay. And we'll stop in the armory to top up our ammo. Alright, we're not alone here. I suppose there's nothing that really indicated there was any inherent safety in here, but I wouldn't have assumed there would be enemies in here. I think we're full up on ammo now. Might as well stop at the med bay as well to heal. I wonder if Anna ever noticed Bakarev just dead there on the floor. You know, considering this is pretty much the end of the game, there's a surprising lack of, like, climactic music or enemies, but then we're a ways off, so. Hold on, I gotta wait for my stamina to come back.
What the?
Now this might be a problem.
Man.
I was gonna sarcastically be like, oh no, not one of these guys, but instead the game upped its ante and they gave us two of these guys. He does look a bit beefier though. Alright, okay, maybe there's more than two. Maybe there's many. Wait, this is a dead end up here. We don't wanna go up there. Okay, fucking wombo comboed in the corner. But I was gonna say, why don't we just not fight them? Instead of dumping all of our ammo into them for no reason.
Locked.
Of course. So we have to go upstairs again. We have to go upstairs again and hit the switch to unlock it. I like how that ground punch does basically nothing. It doesn't even throw off your aim. That wasn't too bad. Wasn't there a third one, though? Like, upstairs? Because that second one popped out of that shipping crate. The cutscene made a big deal about there being one up there.
It's opening.
It's also a little funny how far back that door started getting banged on before it finally got broken open. Honestly, I should have just used the shotgun against them, because it seemed like it stun-locked them. to shoot them in the arm with it. All right, we got some exocells in here. I never noticed that this is just a catwalk above the storm. What these exocells didn't know is that I actually am the storm that is approaching. Alright, so that... I think that's the underwater elevator. We want to go up here. Damn it. I was trying to shoot that canister. Okay, that does throw you off for, like, a second. If you're already aiming. We're gonna need one of those med kits that I've left lying all over the place. And save again. So yeah, now they're giving us a bunch of saves as we get through here. The upper corridor, so this should be where we need to plant it. The question is, where do we need to go? Because we need to get to the heliport from here. So we need to know which direction to run in when it starts collapsing. Heliport module. Okay. Not too bad. Let's see if I can find some health around here. There was some under here? No? I cannot remember at all which ones I've already taken. Nah, those aren't wooden. This music just perpetually playing in this room even when there's no enemies around. So, nothing here. I remember this room. There might be a medkit in the door back here. I'm sure it'll give me a medkit soon, but I just figured I'd be prepared in case it didn't. No? Nothing in here but the MP5. Whatever, let's just go forward and hope we don't get screwed over. Make sure not to overwrite my last save, in case I lose the chance to get a medkit. Okay. I don't remember how to get out of here. This is where I just came from. I swear this is not padding for this episode. I just literally don't know how to get out of this room we just got into. Nope, that's where I just went. So literally anywhere else would be the way out. Okay, we need to go up a different staircase. Or is it out here? Okay, yeah, this is where we came in. Thank fuck I found my way out. Alright, well, let's plant this last charge, and then get out of here. Probably not a great idea to plant charges beneath the helipad, when that's our only way out. But that's a problem for Anna, not for us. What is even exploding here? It was literally just a metal bridge blowing up.
Mission accomplished.
I'm near the walkway between platforms. There's a helicopter on the other one. They were repairing it when I left. If it's working, I can fly us out of here.
You learned to fly a chopper?
I had to do something with my career.
Beautiful.
So just like I thought, Anna knows how to fly a chopper. You know, when you're just getting stir-crazy on the oil rig and they're like, hey, you want some helicopter lessons? But when the cartel's paying for all your fuel, I guess you can afford to take the helicopter out. Oh, there's a medkit. I don't think any of these guys have ammo. I'm pretty sure I searched them all. There's Anishenko again. Of course, you'll notice our objective is still kill Kamsky, but we don't know where Kamsky is. It's been quite a few episodes since we were first in here.
There are two of them?
Grab all this ammo and go. Alright, well, I guess I don't need to worry about overwriting my save, but I'll still save over at the ammo warehouse.
Anna!
Tom! Just a few charges left to set!
Are you just setting them all over the helipad?
Papa?
Hello, Monster Dad.
I'll keep you covered, Anna. Do what you have to. I better keep searching corpses for ammo.
What corpses? I mean, I'm also not bad on ammo. Alright. I was supposed to shoot him immediately to get his attention.
Anna!
Tom! Just a few charges left to...
Hey, big boy. So yeah, what I remember about this boss is that, like the Tyrant in Resident Evil 1, he swings from one side, so you avoid him on the other side.
I have to keep him as far away from that as possible! Unstoppable!
Just a few charges left to set!
We also have the very real danger of being thrown off the oil rig. If he punches us and there's no fence behind us.
I better keep searching corpses for ammo.
Damn it. I like how there's not even like a game over state there. He just grabs her and that's it. That's the end. I mean, I suppose it doesn't really matter what we hit him with. But yeah, if you sprint at him every time, he can't hit you with that attack.
few charges left.
That's like one thing I actually remember from finishing this game originally.
He's unstoppable. I'll have to make myself a target just to keep his attention.
I'm doing that.
I better keep searching for ammo.
You don't have to keep saying that, Tom. I got the gist of it. Okay.
I better keep searching corpses for ammo.
Running pretty low on ammo. Perfect timing.
Get to the chopper. I'll hold him off.
There's no way he's getting through that small fence.
I have the chopper off the ground!
Then get over here!
I can't get close until you kill him!
I'm doing my best! I better keep pushing across this ammo!
Alright. Now how do we kill him? I can tell you, it's not by getting punched across the arena repeatedly.
I better keep searching corpses for now.
Shit, I'm out of stamina. Ouch. I don't actually remember how to hurt him at this point. Thankfully.
Anna.
Never mind. I was about to say thankfully we don't have to do this every time, but I guess we do. Now, from the way he says I should keep searching corpses, I wonder if that means that they have multiple piles of ammo. Ow. Got stomped.
Tom! Just a few charges left to set!
Nope. Looks like... Oh, maybe. I did get the option to search him again, so... I feel like we haven't really heard anything about what this guy's weak point would be.
Just one more!
Do any of these corpses have health? Okay, you kind of ran into him there, Anna. So this part's a little rough.
Anna! Corpses for ammo.
Tom, just a few charges left to set.
I don't know what kind of ammo this corpse is giving us. But yeah, I'm hoping one of these corpses has health packs. It just has some ammo, it doesn't say what kind.
Just one more!
Alright, well, you know, hurry up.
I
day now, Anna. How long does it take to stick a charge to the wall? That probably takes a little bit longer when...
Then get over here!
You're not setting it for 5 seconds.
I'm doing my best! Gonna have to get closer.
Hold on, we had an option to shoot that time. So we do want to get grabbed. Alright, I'm gonna have to start cutting out the first phase because this might take a while. I think I can do it without getting hit, though.
I have the chopper off the ground!
So I think we've got it this time.
I can't get closer!
So he's gonna run at me.
I'm doing my best! This guy seems invincible!
There we go. The only thing is, I don't know exactly which attack we have to watch out for. That is the grab attack. Also, they never really clarified what the other one that looked like him was in the basement. If that was someone else turning into this, or that was actually him. In his, like, resting form. I think this is the only way to kill him. That's not good. Let's get away from that hole. Okay, that was the pistol. I don't think we need anything except pistol. But maybe one of the other guns does more damage? Are you gonna actually come in for a grab, or...? I like how he missed and I didn't even move out of the way. Yeah, I think he still uses the pistol no matter what. So,
it's all right. I'll take care of this.
What about the Exocell?
Goodbye, Papa.
I guess when Anna said that she saved us, she actually did get rid of our Exocell as well. But Tom was still like, oh, I'm just going to die here, even after she said that, so that's why I was unclear. But yeah, I guess we're fine, and we've escaped with Anna. And blown up the oil rig good enough? Oh, this is copyright music, so we're just gonna skip it. Alright, yeah, so that's Cold Fear. Like I said, it's not an amazing game or anything, but I think it's decently fun, and it has kind of an interesting idea. Even if it is, to an extent, kinda Resident Evil 4 on the sea. But yeah, I do think that if this had come out earlier, or even later, than Resident Evil 4, I think this would have got a little bit more attention than it did, but because it launched right before Resident Evil 4, which had way more marketing, it kind of went entirely under the radar. But I'm glad I got to share this, and I did actually enjoy playing it. There was nothing super frustrating about replaying through this, so I think it's a solid middle ground kind of quality of game. And it's interesting to see horror games and whatnot from French developers, because they usually have some unusual ideas. Obscure is another French-developed horror game that I'd like to actually do a full playthrough of, because I am kind of just going through a lot of my backlog right now of games that have been on my list of, hey, I'm going to LP this at some point for years, and there's a lot more to get to. I mean, Obscure is on that list as well, but, you know, Obscure, System Shock 2, Pathologic 2, Stubbs the Zombie. There's just a lot of things in there to dig into while I'm also doing my current LPs. But yeah, who knows when you're gonna actually see those, because this LP you know, I'm on the last episode now, and the first episode's probably not going to come out for like a month or something after this. Anyhow, thank you folks for joining me. I hope you had a good time, and hope you'll join me for the next weird game from my backlog. Until then, y'all take care.